Antarctica, the land of ice and mystery, has been captivating human imaginations for centuries. It's hard to imagine what our world would be like without this icy continent at the bottom of our planet. But have you ever stopped to wonder what would happen if all that ice melted? Would it be a catastrophic event or something we could adapt to? Join us as we take a deep dive into this fascinating topic and explore the potential repercussions of such an unprecedented event. Hold on tight, because things are about to get chilling. A new report by the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, IPCC, has warned that rising sea levels could have a devastating impact on coastal cities around the world. If all of Antarctica's ice were to melt, it could cause global sea levels to rise by as much as 60 meters, 197 feet. This would likely result in the loss of many coastal cities that have low elevations, including Vancouver, London, Hong Kong, Venice, Copenhagen, Mumbai, Calcutta, Buenos Aires, Seattle, Shanghai, and more. The impact of this would be devastating, with huge loss of life and damage to infrastructure. It would also displace millions of people who would need to find new homes. The report warns that this scenario is not unlikely and could happen within the next century if greenhouse gas emissions are not drastically reduced. It is estimated that melting ice in Antarctica could contribute up to 1 meter, 3.3 feet, to global sea level rise by 2100. This would be a catastrophe for many coastal communities around the world that are already struggling with the effects of climate change. Rising sea levels will increase flooding and erosion and make it even harder for people to live in these areas. The IPCC report is a stark reminder of the need for urgent action to address climate change. We must work together to reduce greenhouse gas emissions and protect our planet for future generations. As the world continues to warm, melting ice in Antarctica is already affecting ocean currents and weather patterns. A slowdown of the Atlantic Meridional Overturning Circulation, AMOC, could lead to more extreme weather events in Europe and North America. The loss of these cities would displace many millions of people across the world. These are termed climate refugees. It's already expected that there will be 200 million climate refugees over the next three decades, with temperatures growing by 2 degrees above pre-industrial levels. So, we can expect billions of climate refugees if all the ice melts in Antarctica. Loss of habitat. The melting of the ice in Antarctica could lead to the loss of habitat for many species of plants and animals, including penguins, seals, and krill. These species could potentially become extinct as a result. As the world continues to warm, Antarctica's ice is melting at an increasingly rapid pace. This not only has the potential to cause sea levels to rise significantly, but could also lead to increased ocean acidification. A new study published in Nature Communications has found that if all of the ice in Antarctica were to melt, it would release around 3 trillion tons of carbon into the atmosphere. This would be equivalent to around 10 years of human-caused emissions at current rates. The majority of this carbon would come from thawing permafrost, which contains vast quantities of frozen organic matter. When this decomposes, it releases greenhouse gases like carbon dioxide and methane into the atmosphere. This added carbon would further increase global temperatures, leading to even more ice melting and further release of carbon. It's a dangerous feedback loop that could have disastrous consequences for our planet. In addition to causing climate change, the release of all this carbon would also have a major impact on ocean chemistry. The extra CO2 would make the oceans more acidic, which is already having devastating effects on marine life. Coral reefs are particularly vulnerable, as they rely on a delicate balance of pH to build their skeletons. With increased acidity, they will struggle to grow and thrive. The study's authors warn that we need to take urgent action to reduce our emissions and prevent this nightmare scenario from becoming a reality. If we don't act now, the consequences could be catastrophic. Not just the melting of ice in Antarctica can have a big impact on ocean salinity levels. The ice that forms on land that is below sea level is estimated to be about 23% of the total ice in Antarctica. This means that there is a lot of pressure on the land under the ice. If all of the ice were to melt, the weight on the land would be reduced and it would rise back up over time. This would further push up sea levels as more water is pushed into the ocean. According to a report by the United Nations, rising sea levels could force as many as 200 million people to move from coastal areas by 2050, leading to mass migrations and social upheaval. The report warns that if greenhouse gas emissions are not reduced, sea levels could rise by up to 1 meter by the end of the century. This would have a devastating impact on coastal communities around the world, displacing millions of people and leading to social and economic upheaval. A new report by the World Bank estimates that the economic impacts of rising sea levels and climate change could reach $1 trillion per year by 2050. The report warns that these impacts could lead to recession and even depression, as well as a host of other problems. The report says that rising seas could displace up to 187 million people by 2050, and that climate change could reduce global GDP by as much as $7.9 trillion by 2100. The costs of adaptation could also be high, reaching up to $2 trillion per year by 2050. The World Bank is urging governments to take action to mitigate the effects of climate change and adapt to its impacts. It recommends a number of measures, including increasing investment in clean energy, expanding social safety nets, and improving risk management. A study published in the journal Environmental Research Letters found that rising sea levels and climate change could lead to political instability and conflict in many regions, particularly in areas already facing political and social challenges. The study's authors used a computer model to simulate how different countries would respond to the effects of climate change, including sea level rise, over the next 30 years. They found that rising seas could displace up to 187 million people by 2050, and that many of these people would end up in countries that are already facing political or social unrest. This could lead to increased tensions and even conflict between these countries. A new study has found that melting ice in Antarctica could lead to a loss of tourism in the region, potentially causing significant economic impacts. A new study published in the journal Nature has found that melting ice in Antarctica could create a feedback loop that leads to further ice melt, potentially accelerating the process and making it even more difficult to mitigate the impacts. The ice in Antarctica is not frozen water from the ocean. It's made from many millennia of frozen precipitation, mostly rain and snow. This means that it's freshwater, not salt water. This is important because if it melted, all that freshwater would run into the ocean and dilute the existing salt water. Why is this a problem? Well, ocean currents have a large impact on the global climate. Currents such as the Gulf Stream bring warm waters north where they release heat into the atmosphere. Deep ocean currents then return cold water to the south. If you change the properties of these currents by adding fresh water to them, it could have a major impact on global climate patterns. In addition to affecting global climate patterns, rising sea levels caused by melting ice would also have a huge impact on coastal communities around the world. Sea level rise is one of the most well-documented impacts of climate change, and it's only going to get worse as we continue to emit greenhouse gases into the atmosphere and cause more ice to melt. If we don't take action to reduce our emissions and stop this feedback loop from happening, the consequences could be catastrophic for our planet. In the case of a complete melting of the Antarctic ice sheet, sea levels would rise by a catastrophic 60 meters, 196 feet. This would have a devastating impact on low-lying coastal regions worldwide, leading to flooding, loss of land, and displacement of millions of people. In conclusion, while it is technically possible to live in Antarctica if the ice melted, it would come with significant challenges and risks. The focus must be on preventing climate change and mitigating its impacts to avoid such catastrophic scenarios from occurring.